So the question asks us to find 2023 consecutive integers, but not any integers, positive integers. Let me write that one. And among those integers, we want to have exactly 17 primes. We are asked to prove that this is possible. There is at least one set of 2023 positive consecutive integers that have exactly 17 primes in it. So how can we approach a problem like this? Any ideas? We could look at the first 2023 consecutive positive integers.
I think it has already 17 primes.
And more. Not exactly 17, but more.
Oh,
right.
There is already 17.
Uh-huh. I mean, the 17 prime is like a two-digit number or something. I don't know what exactly it is, but there are definitely more primes than 17, right?
Yeah.
Let this number here be the seventh prime. Now, if the condition positive were removed, we could say that if we started at the 7th prime, 17th prime, and counted all the way backwards, such that we count exactly 2023 integers, then that set of integers would satisfy our condition, right?
Yes.
But the question specifically asks us positive integers. So that's not a solution. That's the first thing that came to my mind when I was looking for a solution, but this is not it. The trick, and I know it's a little bit upsetting that I'm not here to make a well-constructed argument to discover a trick, and I'm just dumping it straight to you. But there are some tricks, there are some ideas that divide your life into two, before you learned it and after you learned it. There's no in-between, not a discovering process. And discrete continuity is an idea like that. Let me write that down. What this principle says in the specific example is that we should be looking for a change when we shift our focus from a specific set of 2023 consecutive integers to the next set, like the integers between 1 and 2023 has definitely more than 17 primes in it. But what about the next 2023 integers? And the next. What is the change? We should be looking at that. So let's look at that in the other board.
Okay, now we are on the edge.
Okay,
it's better.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a random set of consecutive integers. A plus 1, A plus 2, ... A plus 2023. And the next one is A plus. That's definitely out of the range, right?
Not yet.
Really? And now?
It's all in.
Oh, I'm pleasantly surprised by that. First, look at these numbers. When you shift from this set to the next one, like that, what happens to the number of primes in the set that you're looking at? One number is removed and one number is added, right?
Yes.
So there are four different possibilities. This is for the removed number, and this is for the added number.
Okay.
Added number could be a prime or not. There is no other option. And the same applies for the removed one.
Yes.
It's prime or not. So, if both of them are prime, what happens to the number of primes?
It doesn't change.
Yeah.
It stays the same.
Mm-hmm. It's constant. So the net change is zero. Yes. And what happens if the added one is a composite number, but the removed one was a prime number?
It decreases.
Mm-hmm. So the change could be denoted as minus one, right?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And what if the reverse happens?
We'll get a plus one.
It will increase by one. And for the last one, if both of them are not prime numbers, then the change is zero again.
Yes.
So this observation tells us that the number of primes cannot change quickly, like a continuous function. So that's where the name comes from. It's not the same principle as the good old continuity that we all know and love. It just refers to an idea that an integer value changes only by small increments. So let's get back on the first board. And what did we say here? We said that in the first 2023 numbers, we had more than 17 primes.
Mm-hmm.
Let's call it A. As we shift along the number line, the number A will change too.
Mm-hmm.
Like from 2 to 2024, there is not a change. So the number stays A, but in the second shifting, we lose 2, but gain 2025, which is not a prime. So the number of primes decreased by 1. And I don't know and care about the next a few thousand numbers, but I know that at each step, it could be only added one or subtracted one.
Yes.
So, if I also know that A is greater than 17, and at some place it arrives at another number that's smaller than 17, doesn't that mean that as we went along the numbers, there was at least one set with exactly 17 primes? Because there couldn't be any jumps. If a number is 18, the next one cannot be 16. It should pass along a 17. And when it passed along the 17, for which set it passed along the 17 is the set that we are looking for. We don't know exactly which numbers are in that set, but we know that it exists, and it's sufficient to prove the question, right? So we just need to find a B like that. We need to find any set of 2023 consecutive integers with less than 17 primes in it. And the easiest way to do that is just let B equal to zero and look for 2023 consecutive positive integers that has no primes in it. And then we'll be done, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how do we do that? Any ideas? This is a popular construction in number theory questions. We should harness the power of factorials.
Can you repeat that, please?
We should harness the power of factorials.
Harness.
Utilize.
Ah, okay.
Exploit.
Okay. Harness.
Mm-hmm. My man spits out the vocabulary.
Kind of sounds like you are using an animal.
Now again, I just present you 2023 consecutive positive integers that are all composites and leave no explanation for how did I stumble upon these. But when I write these numbers down, I believe that you will understand where these numbers came from, because it's self-explanatory. There are exactly 2023 positive integers, and not a single one of these are prime, because this number is divided by 2, mm-hmm. because 2024 factorial includes 2 as a factor. Mm-hmm. The same goes for 3, 4, and so on. Mm-hmm. If you wanted n consecutive integers with no primes, we would use n plus 1 factorial and the numbers. So that's another fun fact, that for any n, we could construct n consecutive numbers with no primes. Interesting, right? And when our counting process went from the first set, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 2023 to this set, mm-hmm. the number of primes in these sets went from a big number to 0.
Yes.
And in each step, it stayed the same, increased by 1 or decreased by 1, which means that at some point it crossed the number 17, mm-hmm. which means there is a set like that. And that finishes the proof. Let's do the ritual. Looking good?
Yeah, it looks fine.
Do you want to be a part of this joy? The joy of drawing a box and being proud of it, because you now established a truth.
So we just proved it's possible, but we won't find the numbers, right?
Yeah, because who cares? We are mathematicians.
But can you find it?
I mean, this question was asked on the Turkish version of this channel, and when I saw it, I ran a Python script. I left it running for 2 days and it couldn't find it, so I don't know. Theoretically, it's possible to find that.
So, what was the program? What was the program doing?
Let's construct it. Let's write a program to find the first such set. Because why not? When I wrote the code, I started by importing this SignPy module. Specifically the isPrime function, because why would I bother with writing my own prime okay. control function? I'm not using C or something like that. So we have a function called isPrime
okay.
that makes our lives easier.
Okay, now my battery is 5.
Hmm?
5. So I stopped the recording and start the game. Did not lose the video.
Okay. Which portions of my speech were lost?
No, it's not.
Nothing.
I just stopped it and started the game. So
okay.
if it dies, we won't be losing anything important.
A good choice. So I started by including a for loop, but
okay. This
is just Python script. I want to be as universal as possible. So start by 2023 and while true, let's say true.
Mm-hmm.
But we absolutely need to count the first number of primes, right? Just count it somewhere and call a day.
Okay.
It's not a hard task. Okay. While true, check the primality of these two numbers. And assign a new value. A plus is prime. N plus 1 minus is prime. N minus 2022.
Okay.
And if A is equal to 17, break. And when it break, it will print what will it print? N? N would suffice, right?
So it continued for 2 days?
Yeah. On my computer in the dormitory room, and it didn't find anything. We left out an important detail, and I hope it didn't happen in the original. But you need to increase N by 1, you know?
Mm. Yes.
Yes. It really do be like that. And then print the last one. Cidden mi?
Evet.
Kaydetti mi peki?
Kaydetmemiş olabilir bu kısmı.
İnşallah kaydetmiştir.